Folks, at one time or another, you've probably seen a magician take a piece of rope and cut it and put it back together again. I'm going to do the same thing, but I'm going to show you step by step how it was accomplished. Before we start, I'd like to have someone from the audience thoroughly examine this piece of rope, make sure it is in fact what it appears to be, an ordinary, unprepared piece of rope. Would you go over every inch of that?
Do it, Sarah.
Inches, Sarah.
Okay. That's about all the time we have. Now, Sarah. Make sure there are no trap doors and mirrors.
Can I try it out?
Try it out?
Where'd you get that corn dog?
Well, dub bar. It's hot. Now, folks, it's just an ordinary piece of rope, right? It doesn't stretch, just a piece of rope. Folks, here's the idea. The magician first is going to measure the rope carefully. You want to make sure that when you cut, you get two pieces of rope exactly the same length. So you measure carefully like so. Now, to put these back together again, you tie a Mongolian pop knot. Here's how it is tied. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have one Mongolian pot knot. Everybody with me so far? It's a Mongolian pot knot. It was invented by the famed horsemen of Mongolia. It's a kind of a slip knot. Sometimes those boys had to leave town in kind of a hurry. To make it work, you have to put some pixie dust on it. Now this, I call it pixie dust. I don't know what they call it in Mongolia. In a few seconds, that pixie dust will cause the knot to dissolve and pop right off the rope, leaving you where you started from with one long piece. Some of you may have had a hard time seeing exactly how to tie that knot, especially those of you in the cheaper seats. So we'll do it again. This time we'll cut the rope into three even pieces. That gives you twice as much chance to see how the knot is tied, since it takes two Mongolian pop knots in order to put three pieces of rope back together again. Am I going too fast? That very seldom happens. Now, folks, remember when you try this at home, make sure you cut all three pieces of rope the same length. If you make a mistake here, the trick won't work. For example, if instead of cutting three ropes all the same length, you were to make a mistake and get one of the ropes just a little bit short, the trick won't work. If you get one rope about right and the other rope too long, the trick won't work. All three ropes have to be the same length. And this could happen to anyone. So if it happens to you, there is a way out. As long as I am teaching you the trick, I'll teach you what we magicians call a contingency plan. You make a mistake cutting the ropes, you fold them over one at a time like this: short, medium, and long. And you say the magic word, simsalabim. You have to say these with a certain amount of conviction. Sim salabim. I know it's so stupid, but it works, see? It works. That's the way it makes some stretch, right? I know, it's magic. All the same length. Now, back to the Mongolian pop knot. We take rope number one, rope number two. I'm going to tie these together. Watch closely, I'll go slow. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time. I fail to see the humor in that. I don't think I'm alone in that either. You twist, come around and pull tight. You have one Mongolian pop knot. Second knot is tied the same way. You may want to take notes. Take one rope, twist around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have two Mongolian pop knots. Everybody with me so far?
Yeah.
At this point, you simply reach in your pocket, you take some magic, pixie dust, very good, very studious. Sprinkle the pixie dust on the knots like this. Any questions so far?
Where do we get the pixie dust?
where do we get the pixie dust? Well, I grind my own. Not just for economy, but for purity. Any other stupid questions? The only way we're going to learn, in a few seconds, the pixie dust will cause the knots to dissolve and pop right off the rope, leaving you where you started from. With one.